السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته صبايا، بتمنى السلامة للجميع. اليوم محاضرتنا هتكون في الليدرشيب شابتر 3 Total Quality Management Leadership، استكمالا للمحاضرات اللي توقفنا فيها عندها في الجامعة. First of all, we will define leadership. Okay. Leadership is to do good things. Efficient management without effective leadership is a waste of time. You know, every not all manager leader and all leader are manager. Leadership is very important in all organizations to achieve its goals. And to have a good communications with the customers. And because of the importance of leadership, total quality management goals will be achieved through the good leadership rules. First of all, I will identify the leadership as here defined it as leadership is the process of influencing others toward the accomplishment of goals. Now, what are the characteristics of good leaderships to achieve quality? Here, he defined 12 characteristics. First of all, the customer first. We know that quality management, total quality management, focusing on a customer. So in leadership, the characteristic of leaderships, both the main priorities for achieving is to satisfy customers' needs. Then the value people, quality leaders take care of development of people's skills and capabilities. They give value for people that they work with. Third one, build supplier partnership. They clarify quality to suppliers. Then empower people. They coaching people and training them to empower them in their work. Then the demonstrate involvement commitment. Leaders continually demonstrate their commitment to quality. Strive for excellence. Quality leaders emphasize continuous improvement rather than maintenance. Explain and deploy policy. Always the leaders must identify the policy to involve employees in achieving their goals. Improve communications. You know, leaderships emphasize or always focusing on good communication, two-way communication between the members. Promote teamwork. They promote multidisciplinary teamwork, create involvement and active participations of everyone, benchmark continuously. Quality leaders learn from problems. You know, leaders are encourage employees to involve and to be more creative and to present ideas. So they have continuous do benchmark and create new learning effects through innovations. Establish system. They establish organizational systems to support the quality efforts. Encourage collaboration. They encourage collaboration rather than competition. You take that, I think, in organizational behavior. Now, we will talk about the leadership style for effective leaders. First of all, directing style of leadership, consultative style, participative style and delegating style. First of all, directing style, we talk about the authoritative style and the consultative style. We talk about this leadership is used when a leader is seeking input from those working under him. Encourage the participation. Participative style, a leader assign works to the employees, provide guidance during the work process, and make the decision based on the contributions of employees working on the task. Now, delegating style. Delegating style, the leaders essentially tells the employees or the team what need to do to be done, assigns the responsibility, and provide the individual or team with authority to get the job done. Now, what are the requirements of effective leadership? We need to have an effective leadership vision, empowerment, institutions, self-understanding, and value congress. Vision. Here, identify each requirement. First of all, we will talk about vision. Vision is critical for the leaders during times of change. They need it through the vision to have an opportunity to achieve total quality management. Empowerment, a leader should empower employees to assume ownership of problems or opportunities. Institution, leaders usually follow their institutions. They must be prepared to make difficult decisions. Self-understanding requires the ability to look at oneself and then identify relationships with employees and within the organization. Now, the last one is the value congruence. Value congruence occurs when leaders integrate their value into the company system. Now we will talk about the domain 14 points for management. First point about the create consistency of purpose for continual improvement of product and service. Adapt the philosophy. Accuse dependence and expectation, and the practice of awarding business on the basis of a price. Improve constantly and forever the system. Intensive training, leadership, drive out fear. Create the trust, create a climate for innovation. Break down barriers between department and individual. Eliminate exploitation for the workforce. Eliminate anomical quotas for workforce. Remove barriers that rob people of pride of workmanship. Encourage education and self-improvement. Take action to accomplish the transformation. All of these are explanation of each point. Now we will talk about the role of senior management. Hina, in practice, the total quality management effort has been led by members of senior management. The responsibility of senior managers are to study the and investigate total quality management concepts, to set clear quality policy and provide challenging tasks, to establish priority of quality and customer satisfaction as the basic policy and determine the long-term goals. To bring a culture charge required for total quality management effort. To establish the total quality management vision. To become coaches and cheerleaders for encouraging and supporting the managers. To stimulate employees to be involved. To teach employees to realize that the company's interest and their interest are ground to into another. To uphold norms and values and let it be known. To attend total quality management training programs. To create coordinations and harmony among within the or department. To monitor whether quality improvement programs are conducted or as planned. To create a basic trust, respect, and open communication. Now, leading participate. So for leadership, most of leadership participants are common among the firms committed to quality. Quality and business performance are promoted by true leadership in several ways. Now we will talk about the several ways that how the leaders will performance in the business to achieve quality or total quality management. First of all, leaders focus on create and balance value for customer. We know first of all that total quality management put the customer in the center, and the most important goals for total quality management to satisfy customer needs and wants. Leaders create and sustain a leadership system and environment for empowerment. They must achieve empowerment, empower their employees, innovations to create new ideas, agility, and organizational learning, because they have a continuous improvement for skills and continuous of improvement for the employees. Leaders integrate quality value into delay leadership and management and communicate. Leader review organizational performance, include their own performance as a leader to assess organizational success and progress. They always review their performance. It's about the performance appraisal for themselves and the organization as a whole and the employees in the organization. To continuous improvement to achieve leadership effectiveness. Leaders create an environment that foster legal and ethical behavior. And integrate public responsibility and community support into their business practices. Now we will talk about the quality council. What it is, what we mean about the quality council. It's about we talk about the team to provide overall directions for achieving the total quality management culture. Total quality management, it's not a program that I will apply in one department. No, it's a culture for the whole organization. It's a concept that all organization will apply. So it's need a team, and this team will consist of all senior and all the top management in the organization. So the first of all, we define it as a team.
It's performed in the organization with an objective of building. What its objective? Why we build this team? To build quality into the culture of the organization. Total quality council consists of chief executive officer, senior manager of the functional areas such as design, marketing, finance, production, and quality. Quality council coordinates our coordinator and consultants. What are the objective of quality council? Why we will create quality council? To raise the quality, to ensure effective functioning of the organization, to encourage basic and applied research and development, to raise the level of training of personnel engaged in quality activity, to facilitate upgraduation of testing and collaboration facilities. The duties of quality council. To what is the tasks of duties council? First of all, to establish the core value and quality statement. When we talk about culture, we talk about the value, the core value of the organizations. We will talk about the vision, mission, statement, the policy in the organization. To establish the strategic long-term plan with goals and the annual quality improvement program with objectives. To plan the training and education programs to determine and monitor the cost of poor quality. To perform and monitor the performance measures for each functional area of the organization to determine continually those projects that improve the processes, particularly those that affect external and internal customer satisfaction, to establish multifunctional projects and determine the departmental teams and monitor their programs, to establish the recognition and reward system periodically. The responsibility of the quality council coordinator to develop two-way trust. It's about communication. They must have two-way communication. You know what we mean about two-way. To propose team requirements to the council, to share council expectation with the team, to empower the team, to brief council on team progress. Now, the quality structure, it's about where this quality council are located in the organization. As we know, first of all, we say that it's as a coordinator and consultants. Here it consists of chairperson, senior managers of main functions concerned the division, who is a member of a corporate quality council. Okay. Now, strategic quality planning. What is strategic planning? First of all, it's a set. Sets the long-term directions of the organization in which it wants to process it in the future. When we talk about strategic, we talk about the long-term of a plan. In quality council, we say that one of its tasks to put quality as a culture in the organization. So we will determine the culture of quality in the strategic of the organization. he define the differences between the goals, the objectives, and the plans. We know the differences between them. First of all, goals, it's based on the vision and mission of the company, and it's are set are attempted to improve the organization. It's improve the customer satisfaction, cost reduction, improve the shareholder value, and improve market value. Share. Objective represent the operational definition of goals and can be measured. The plans typically describe specific tactics, assigns the responsibility, identify how source can be allocated, schedule activities or and efforts, and specify the target, vision targets. Now we will talk about the strategic planning process. Seven steps to strategic planning. First of all, identification of customer needs, determine the customer positioning, predict the future gap analysis, choose closing the gap. Steps number six, align the plan with the mission and vision. Implementation of the plan. Re-evaluate and review the last steps. Okay. Now, we will talk about the differences between the strategic quality planning and traditional strategic planning. In strategic quality planning, it's focusing on customer. The traditional focuses is not defined or is separate among many considerations. Here we mean about this in strategic quality planning, the most important goal and the center is the customer. In the traditionally, they don't put just the customer in the main, the topic of our goals. No, they say define many consider, they put many consideration. Now leaders determine vertical success factors. In the traditional leaders lack understand of factors vertical to success. Goals and objectives on strategic quality are processes and results oriented, and traditionally are result oriented. Okay, in strategic quality are goals and the organized objectives are based on data and are driven by trends or pattern analysis, but in the traditional may be based on hunches or guesses. Strategic quality focus on processes, but in traditions on products and in the output. In traditions, we focusing on the output, but in strategic quality, we are focusing on the processes to avoid if defects, to avoid the loses of loses and to have a correct from the first steps, not to have to have wrongs and make mistakes, then we correct. Because the concept of quality, we know that make a correct from the first time, so we focusing on the processes. But in traditionally, we wait for the product to produce, and then we find out the wrong or the defects in the product. Now, alignment exists between critical success factors, mission, vision, goals, objectives, and day-to-day activity. In tradition, no alignment exists. And strategic quality planning, everyone knows how he or his day-to-day activities. In tradition, few people know how their day-to-day activities fit in the with the plan. Here we talk about empowerment. Empowerment enables people to know how what they do, what their role in achieving goals of the organization. Improvement on strategic quality are focus on activities critical to success. But in traditional improvement activities lack focuses. Improvement activities are both within and across functional areas. In traditional are usually within functional areas. Here, now we finish this chapter.